Hi, welcome to the very first lecture for web design guidelines. In this lecture, I am going to give you a little startup for web design because it is difficult to cover all aspects of web design in a single course. So, what web design is? Web design is a process of planning and creation of a whole website. The term web design is normally used to describe the front end of a website, which is mainly related to styling and page layouts, including text and images. The term web design and web development is often used interchangeably, and technically web design is a subset of broader category of web development. Web design elements include wireframing, user experience, web design layouts, graphic design, site structure, navigation, typography, colors, icons, and etc. I will try to cover most of them during this course. Web design is divided into two parts, front-end and back-end. As I mentioned before, the term web design is normally used to describe the front-end of a website. So, front-end is what user sees, which includes look and feel of a website. Front-end developer normally use technologies like HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to design the front-end of a website. Back-end is basically how the site works. It refers to the part which user don't see. Lot of time backend is classified as web programming. Nowadays, the web design is totally changed. It looks more attractive, user-friendly, and different type of web designs are there. And the major improvement is responsiveness of web design. So it is better to always get inspiration to new web design layouts. Well, web design needs careful thinking and planning, and most important thing is knowing the website audience. Before we move forward, I would like you to download the resource file which is attached with this course, because in the next chapter I am going to cover wireframing, so you might need some resources for that. See you in next lecture. Thanks.